and I'm back with another tone and shape for you today. So make sure you've got enough space around you, there's no obstacles in the way. Pop some water at the side if you need it, and you can use either the high or the low impact options. Find yourself some good motivational music and put that on, and that'll help you as well. So starting off with our warm up, we're going to step touch, and we're going to take the arms forward and out. Keeping your shoulders back and down. Take it into a step knee lift. So we're going to take the arms up and out if you can. If that's too much, if you've got a bad shoulder, just take them forward and out instead. Back to your step touch. Knee lift. Pulling your tummy slightly in. Standing up nice and tall. We're going to walk it forward for three and tap and then walk it back. So if you've not got the space to move, then you can just do it on the spot if you prefer. Your step touch. So we're taking the arms forward and out, shoulders down. Step knee lift. Walking forwards and back, you just swing the arms on the walks. We're going to take into a step curl now. So feet are wide and you're bringing your heel up towards your bottom. On the top, step touches. Step knee lift. Last four, into the walks forward and back. And step curl. If you want to on this one, we can reach the arms up. We're going to do it all through one more time. So back to your step touches. Step knee lift. Lean forward on this one, keep standing up nice and tall. Walking forward. Step curl, heel to your bottom. again with your arms. You can either keep them where they are, or you can reach them up, pulling your shoulder blades down your back. And let's hold it there. So you're going to bring one foot forward, one foot back, hands on your bent leg, front leg straight, back straight, for your hamstring stretch. You can either hold it there, or you can lift your front toes off the floor. And stepping your back foot further back, make sure all your toes are facing forward, bending your front knee, pushing into your back heel. Feel the stretch in your calf and your back leg first, and once you've got that, take your arms out, bring your chin towards your chest. Really push into your back heel, don't let it lift off the floor. Release, lift your back heel, bend your knees, give me a little tuck under. We're going to bring one arm round, holding between the elbow and the wrist. And switch legs. So front leg straight, back leg bent. Again, hands on the bent leg. Just make sure you're not pushing on your kneecap. It wants to be on your thigh. And you can either keep your toes where they are, or you can lift them off the floor. Taking your back foot further back, toes are all forward, bend your front knee, push into your back heel, getting the calf stretch first. Once that's there, hands go in the small of your back, and all you're doing is bringing your elbows in towards one another. So just opening out through the chest. You can lift the chin slightly, we're not leaning backwards. Release the hands, lift the heel, bend your knees, little tuck under with the hips, and bring the other arm round, hand between the elbow and wrist, reach across for your shoulder stretch. And come on. So we're going to start with a narrow squat, so feet underneath the hips, toes facing forward, and just make sure when you do your squat that your knees go in the same direction as your toes and they're not coming in towards each other. So we're going to do one squat, and as we come up, take the weight out to the side, come back in, squat, take the weight out to the side. So we're going to do this for 30 seconds. Okay, off we go, squat and out. So how far down you go is entirely up to you, depends how you feel. Just keep the back straight, keep the knees going in the same direction as the toes, and keep your knees over your ankles. Keep going. Okay, last two. Next one, two options. So for your low impact option, you're gonna curl, you're gonna move your hands really, really fast. For your high impact option, you're gonna kick your bum and move your hands really fast. So off you go, 30 seconds. Hands going faster. Don't hit yourself in the face though. You can move them a bit higher if you're worried about hitting yourself in the face. Keep going. I'm just going to show you that low option again. So you can keep the hands going really fast and just take it into that curl. 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring the feet back underneath the hips. We're going to do 1, 2, and on 3, punch forward and lift the knee. Okay, off you go. 1, 2, 3. Now pull your tummy in. You can do an inhale and then a sharp exhale on that punch if you want to. So tummy's nice and tight, but making sure we're not holding our breath. Keep going, you're nearly there. Last two. Last one. Well done. Okay, so low option. We're going to keep the hands here and you're going to try and tap your knees to your hands. High option, high knees. Okay, let's go. High option. Keep going. Low option. is. Slow that down a little bit for me. Bringing the heart rate down. Deep breaths in through your nose, out through your mouth. Are we ready to go again with them all? Let's have a look. Okay, so we're starting off with the narrow squats and tap out. Knees going in the same direction as your toes. Tummy's in. Back stays straight. Try looking forwards rather than down at the floor. Nearly there. Last two. So we're going to jog and keep the bottom. Now off you go. Low option is your curl. Punch those arms. Go as fast as you can round and round. Okay, high option. Far enough away from your face, you're not going to hit yourself. Nearly there. Four, three, two, and stop. We've got the twist, twist, knee. Off you go. Remember, you can take a breath in and then out as you lift the knee. In tight, but you're still breathing, you're not holding your breath. Nearly there. Last two. Well done. Low option, high option, off you go. Can you tap your knees without lowering your hands? Breather is rewind it back 2.5 minutes and do it one more time. That's going to make your workout a little bit longer. Grab a little drink if you need one. Now, if you need to keep going here for a little bit longer, you can do. Just pause the video, step slowly until you're ready to join back in. So the first exercise we're going to do, we're going to just bend the knees, bring the hands to the floor, walk forward, hold it for a couple of seconds, bend the knees and come back up. Now if you don't like the height difference, if you get a bit dizzy, go down and just do a plank either on your forearms or your hands, and you can keep your knees down if you need to. So are we ready? 30 seconds. Let's have a look. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Make sure the knees are not dropping, sorry, not the knees, the hips are not dropping towards the floor. Looking down towards the fingers. Don't let the head drop too low. This is going to be your last one. Hold it. 3, 2, 1, bring your legs straight. Okay, we're going to do a roll up. So, I'm going to take the legs out in front. Just move that down a bit so you can see. Legs are out in front. You can either have them straight or slightly bent if you need to. Tucking the pelvis under, make a C curve with your spine. You can either stop here for a half
and come back up. Or we can roll all the way down, vertebra by vertebra, head goes down. Then using your out breath to lift yourself up. Off you go. Tucking the pelvis under, holding it in the tummy. Inhale, and then use your exhale to help lift you up. Now this shouldn't be a fling. The leg shouldn't lift off the floor here, so we don't want to fling, we want to use the stomach muscles. Sitting up tall, tucking under, inhale, and use your out breath to lift you back up. Let's do one more. I think we've done more than 30 seconds, but never mind. From there, hands are going to come behind. So if it hurts your wrists like this, you can do it on a fist instead. Option one, you're going to have the knees bent. And what we're trying to do is lift the bottom off the floor, but I want you to look at your knees. Option two, you can extend the legs and lift your bottom off the floor. So either of those two options, off you go. Looking at the knees, try to keep your shoulders down away from your ears. So it's dead easy to sort of shrug and come down here, but we want to lift, lift up and lift the bum. Hold it there. Feet are slightly apart, knees are slightly apart. Arms are roughly under your shoulders. Four, three, two, down you come. Onto your back. Option one, breathe in. As you breathe out, lift one leg. Breathe in and lower. Breathe out and lift. So if you need to keep one foot on the floor, if you've got a bad back, you can do this. Alternatively, hold your tummy in, push your lower back down, lift the other leg. And what we're gonna do, as one leg goes down, the other leg's gonna come up. So you can keep it there, or you can lift your head and shoulders off the floor. So off you go when you're ready. Any of those three options is fine. So keep going with this one if that's the one you want to do. Just a reminder of the others, lift and lower. So you can do this one with your head lifted off the floor. If your head and neck are fine lifted, then this is absolutely an option. Four, three, two, one, sit yourselves up. You're going to have a little rest. So they are your four exercises for on the floor. If you remember, we began stood up. So if you don't want to stand up, if you don't want to keep getting up and down, then come round into the plank position, which you can either do on your forearms and stay on your knees. You can do it straight arm and stay on your knees, or either lift the legs. If you're going to do the walk out with me, then up you come. When you're ready. Bending the knees, walking the arms forward. Hands should be underneath the shoulders, looking just in front of the hands, and then rolling back up. So the plank is a great all over body exercise. Works everything. Let's do one more. And down you come. Ready for the roll up? So you can do the half or the full. It's up to you. Off you go. So the half, we're going to tuck under and hold and then come up and over. So it's really important that we start with a flat back and then we tuck the pelvis under and get this C curve. And then these vertebras hit the floor one at a time and use your out breath to pull yourself back up. That tuck under is really important. If you've got a bad back and it's hurting, do the half, but don't take it back as far. Just take it a little bit back and come back up, or try it with your knees bent. We're just going to do one more. into the seated leg pull. Hands can go wherever's comfortable or in your fist if you need to. And you can either do it with the knees bent or with the legs straight. So off we go, we're going to lift up, keeping the shoulders down, looking towards your toes or towards your knees if you've got your knees bent. Don't let the shoulders sag. Lift up, get your bum up if you can. If you need to rest in between, that's absolutely fine. You don't have to hold it the whole time. Just hold it for as long as you can. Come down and then go back up again when you're ready. Nearly there, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're gonna lie down. So, options are one leg at a time, or hold the tummy in, push the lower back down, lift the other leg. You can lift your head and shoulders if you want to. And let's go with the tap. Really control it, and when you tap your foot down, your back shouldn't be lifting off the floor. So if it is, take it back to the option with one foot down. Your stomach muscles aren't strong enough yet. Four more. 3, 2, and 1. Place it down, relax your head back, just hug that leg in. So you're holding behind your thigh, letting your heel drop towards your bottom. And then take the leg up, hold above or below your knee, relax the foot, bring the leg towards you. Ease off, now flex. Pull your toes down, calf stretch. And relax, bend the knee, turn out. So you can either stay there, or if you're able to, you're going to grab hold behind. If you've had any knee operations, then I'll just leave it there. So we're going to hug the other leg in behind the thigh, heel drops towards the bottom. And then extend, hold above or below your knee, bring that leg towards you, relaxing the foot. Then ease off, now flex, calf stretch. Bend, turn out from your hip, and again just leave it there, or you can take hold behind. And relax, take your time, you're going to roll onto your side and then sit yourself up. You can either sit with your legs out or with your legs crossed, whatever's comfortable. Sit up nice and tall, take your arms out in front, shoulders are down, drop your chin towards your chest. And you should get a stretch across the top of your shoulders. Release, take the hands back, squeeze your hands in towards one another, keeping the shoulders down. One arm comes round, shoulder stretch. And the other side. When you're ready, you're going to stand up and we're going to stretch out our thighs. If you can't do this stretch, back heel off the floor, knees bent, little tuck under. And if you can, you're going to grab hold of your heel. Bring your thighs level and push your hips forward. So that's going to give you that extra thigh stretch. If you need more of a stretch, you can push this foot down towards the floor at the same time as pushing your hips forward. And same on the other side. So we're going to push the hips forward, push the foot down towards the floor. Hold on to the side if you need to. And relax, take a deep breath in. Moving one arm up, we're going to reach over to the side. And change sides. And take one more breath in, giving yourselves a huge round of applause. Well done. If you've done it, let me know. Comment below. Let me know what you think. If there's any exercises you want to see, let us know. Thanks very much, everyone.